doing this amazing, this is an amazing chapel. What a privilege to be a part of this. It is an honor to serve as your state senator. Representing your interests and values, the gate of Oregon's legislative body. However, my ability to serve is owed to those before me who have served selflessly and fought wholeheartedly to preserve freedoms as our nation. From the early veterans of the American Revolution and the Civil War, the Spanish-American War to World War I, World War II, Korean, Vietnam, Desert Storm, and the War Against Terror. And to those who served during times of peace, numerous tours of duty around the world during the periods between the wars and all branches of our insurgents. Collectively, veterans who preceded us, if they survived the wars, returned home and continued to serve our nation, returning home to raise families, farm our land, to feed our growing nation, build our national railroad, interstate system, lay cable for electric phone, and work in our factories. Our nation's economic prosperity was not inherited, and it did not come easy. It came at a high price to many families and the loss of husbands and wives, sons and daughters, brothers, sisters who served, and perhaps the mental health issues that remained due to the trauma encountered during battle. I have not served in the military, but I am the spouse of a veteran. I am the daughter of a veteran, and I'm the granddaughter of a veteran. And I'm here to share that the sacrifices are real, significant, and should never be forgotten. Respect and honor of our military is a deep and core Boles family value. My father was in the Vietnam War. He wasn't drafted, he volunteered. To this day, he cannot talk about his experience. It comes out in different and not always beneficial ways. My parents divorced when I was 5. My family did not survive the after effects of that war. While I am sure there are many contributing factors, my dad's long battle with the impact of the war has followed him and us. I imagine there are people in this room who can understand this. But despite the difficulty of that experience, it left my dad and us a profound respect for the courage it takes and the benefits that we all receive. We've all heard the phrase, freedom isn't free. Isn't that the truth? And despite these losses of loved ones and challenges with mental health and physical health conditions, came the rise of resilience we see in so many veterans. A willingness to wake up every day, show up for work, look for ways to engage their fellow veterans and serve their community and service organizations. Veterans continue to serve long after they have left the armed services. Thank you. One of my favorite quotes that inspires my work is that of veteran and Republican President Teddy Roosevelt. It is a quote that gained popularity in recent years of Brene Brown's Daring Greatly and Daring Lead. And I quote, "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows at the end triumph of high achievement, and at worst, if he fails, at least he fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold, timid souls who neither know victory or defeat." So despite great feelings of anxiety and fear at times, veterans chose to rise when asked by their country and volunteer to serve selflessly. So today we can sit comfortably in these seats and enjoy the freedoms guaranteed to all Americans in our Constitution. Our veterans, those of you in this room, committed to action. They showed great courage, sacrifice, selflessness, dedication, protecting deep and abiding American values. The willingness to give up one's life so that we may live and be free. Wow. They truly lived out Jesus' command. Love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. So today, I want to offer my sincere thank you. Your service is significant. Our country owes you a tremendous debt of gratitude. And please know, I do think of your sacrifice every single day I serve as your state senator. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
marched, sailed, and flew into battle for our country with all of their heart, soul, mind, and strength. The sacrifices of those we knew and of those known but to God will be forever remembered and honored. The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is an especially eloquent memorial built to pay tribute specifically to the unnamed veterans who undoubtedly deserve to be recognized for what they've done for our freedom. The tomb is located atop of a beautiful hill overlooking the city of Washington, D.C. at the Arlington National Cemetery. It was first built November 11, 1921, with endless amounts of honor, love, and care. Our nation believes that all soldiers, no matter how big or small their sacrifice, should be dignified and commemorated. To demonstrate this belief, the memorial has been guarded every minute of every day since 1937, by the most respectable soldiers from the United States Army. From the early hours of the morning, the perfectly trained Tomb Guard sentinels stand motionless for 1 hour straight, 2 hours during the night, protecting the solemn memorial. Every hour the soldiers change guard, a special ceremony is held in which a magnificent wreath is placed in front of the tomb to show our respect for the unknown veterans. This wreath symbolizes the bravery and generosity of every soldier who prayed and fought for our freedom. The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is significantly important for both the unnamed soldiers and for our country and individual citizens of America. The tomb's elegant white marble walls are engraved with Greek symbols representing peace, victory, and valor alongside the famous phrase, "Here rests in honor glory an American soldier known but to God." This statement holds great meaning in many ways. It does not only represent Lieutenant Michael Blassie, who lies inside the tomb, but also every soldier he represents, whose names or bodies were not found or identified. It gives us the hope that, like Michael Blassie, we will be able to find the soldiers' identities and bring their legacy home to their families to be honored forever. It demonstrates the immense influence that all soldiers have on our country. Just as Christ Jesus sacrificed himself for an unworthy people, these fearless sailors, Marines, Coast Guards, and pilots charged into battle, knowing what the outcome would be, but following through due to the love for their country and fellow citizens. They were significant in every life of every American. Without them, our nation would not be free. My family would not be free. We would not be free. We owe our lives to every known and unknown soldier there is, because they are the ones that provided us with that life. The tomb also brings significant meaning to me personally. It proves the all-powerful ability of God to work through others. It shows the undying loyalty and love of soldiers for their country and others. It means to me that every single person who sacrificed their life was not sacrificed in vain. They saved every mother, father, and child brought up in the land of free. While they were marching into war, each and every soldier was thinking of the life they needed to provide for their family, friends, and even me. The honor of laying the wreath at the changing of the guard meant the world to me. It gave me a chance to thank every veteran for what they did for me and my family. It gave me a feeling of closure to know that I could finally repay them, thank them, and honor them for every atonement they gave for my life, my happiness, and my security. In conclusion, for men and women across the world, the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is an indelible place of honor and safety for them to express their feelings of gratitude and respect for both their lost ones and those known to God. It expresses meanings of great importance to the unknown, to our country, and to the individual lives of every single American citizen. It symbolizes the love of every Marine, sailor, Coast Guard, and pilot who is sacrificed, and it allows us to repay them for everything they have done for our lives. The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is a great symbol of love, honor, and glory, and proves how truly proud every citizen is to be an American. Thank you.